Today, we'll be taking a look at how to make your voice sound better using Audacity. We'll take a look at how to properly record your audio, apply a few effects, and export your audio for use on Final Cut Pro or whatever else you use to edit videos. Hey guys, what's up? My name is Serge and welcome back to my channel. Audacity is a very powerful open source audio editing software that has some great effects you might not have in your video editing software such as Final Cut Pro. And the best part of it all is it's completely free. You can download Audacity from their website, which I'll link in the video description below. Let's jump into Audacity and first take a look at how to record your audio. You have two options here. You can either record your audio right in Audacity, or you can import your camera audio file. If you want to know how to do that, I got you covered. First thing we need to do is connect our microphone and set our audio levels. For my voiceovers, I use a Blue Yeti microphone, and for the price, this thing is awesome. Next, if at all possible, eliminate any background noise, such as fans, air conditioners, or anything else you might hear in the background. Audacity does have a great noise removal tool, but this can make your voice sound a little bit tinny, so only use this as a last resort. In Audacity, from this drop-down menu, select your microphone. Click anywhere in this audio monitoring panel and start talking at your normal volume. Use a gain adjustment on your mic, or this gain slider, to adjust the levels so majority of your audio is around negative 12 decibels. This will give you a lot of headroom, so if you get excited and a bit too loud, your audio won't clip. If you have this set too high and your audio clips,
it'll sound like this.
Setting the input levels lower will prevent this from happening. Hit the record button and record your voiceover.
Hey guys, what's up? My name is Serge, and today we'll take a look at how to make your voice sound better using Audacity.
When done, click the stop button to stop recording. After recording, first thing we want to do is apply an equalizer to our clip. Press Command A to select your entire clip, and from the menu bar select Effect and Equalization. Now, this is very objective, but what I find works best for me is bringing up the high and the low frequencies. To bring up the high frequencies, click on the line around 4000 Hz and add a control point. Add another control point at around 5000 Hz. Click on the second control point and drag this up to about 9 decibels. To bring up the low frequencies, add a control point at about 500 and 100 Hz. Drag up the last control point to around 9 to 10 decibels. You can preview your audio to see what it's going to sound like by clicking this preview button.
Hey guys, what's up? My name is Serge, and today we'll take a look at how to make your voice sound better using Audacity.
Play around with these settings to match your voice. Once you're happy with the sound, click OK. Next step is to amplify your audio. Once again, from the menu bar select Effect, and this time select Amplify. This is going to want to bring up the peaks of your audio to 0 decibels. This is what we want for now, so let's click OK. This effect will bring up our volume as much as possible without clipping any part of the track. Next thing we want to do is level out our audio so there isn't so much difference between the loud and the soft parts. For this, we'll use compressor. From the menu bar, select Effect and Compressor. There's a few adjustments we need to make here. First up is a threshold slider. This tells Audacity the level above which to start compressing noise. Set this to about negative 12 decibels. Only parts of your audio louder than 12 decibels will get compressed. On the other end of the spectrum is the noise floor. This limits the quiet background sounds from being affected by this effect and prevents you from unnecessarily amplifying these noises. Set this to around 50 decibels. The ratio slider sets a compression ratio. For most voiceovers, a 2:1 or a 3:1 ratio works best. The next two sliders set how fast the compressor kicks in and out. Bring these all the way down. And last is the makeup gain to 0 decibels checkbox. Selecting this will amplify your entire waveform after compression to bring peaks back up to 0. All these combined will compress your louder passages while at the same time amplifying your softer passages for a more consistent volume level. And last step, and this should always be done last, is normalizing your audio for final output. From the menu bar, select Effect and Normalize. If your voice will be the only audio in your mix, set this value to about -1. If there will be other audio in your project, such as sound effects or background music, set this number to -3. Hit OK. So this is what the original audio sounded like.
Hey guys, what's up? My name is Serge, and today we'll take a look at how to make your voice sound better using Audacity.
And this is the same audio after all these effects.
Hey guys, what's up? My name is Serge, and today we'll take a look at how to make your voice sound better using Audacity.
Last thing we need to do is export our audio for use in Final Cut Pro. From the menu bar, select File and Export Audio. Give your track a name, choose the file type, and select the save destination. Hit Save. This exported file is now ready to be imported and used in your video project. I did a video a few weeks ago about round-tripping audio from Final Cut Pro into Audacity and back into Final Cut Pro. If you haven't seen it yet, check it out. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to hit the like button and check out the rest of my channel for more Audacity and Final Cut Pro tutorials. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you back here next week.